Now we come to our next section of the book of Revelation, chapter 19, which describes the marriage supper of the Lamb in heaven, which you can see on this large chart as illustrated by this supper. There will be a real marriage feast in heaven just before the literal coming of Christ to the earth. All the saints of all the ages, from Abel down to the end of the tribulation, who will have part in the first resurrection, will have a banquet with Jesus Christ in heaven before they get on their white horses and come down to the earth to fight the battle of Armageddon. If you take the statements of chapter 19, the first 10 verses, has a picture of a literal and a real supper in heaven, why, I don't need to stop to explain any detail of that for you. It's just as literal as it reads. The marriage of the Lamb is come, and his wife hath made herself ready. And it was granted to her so that she should be arrayed in fine linen, clean and white, which is the righteousness of the saints. Then in verse 11 he says, I saw heaven opened, and behold, a white horse. And he that sat upon him was called faithful and true. And in righteousness he doth judge and make war. In verse 14, we read the armies of heaven followed him on white horses, clothed in linen white and clean. Now you say, is that literal? Well, that's the way it reads. I know what a horse is, and I know what fine linen is. I've seen a little of it. I've never worn any, I don't think. But I know what a supper is, and I know all the words in this English description here of these facts, so I don't know any other thing to do but to take it literally. There are horses in heaven. There are animals in heaven. People can ride horses after the resurrection just like they can ride horses before the resurrection. They've tried to do it all. It isn't hard. It doesn't take you long to learn to ride a horse, you know. Anyway, here we have the armies of heaven coming on white horses, clothed in linen, white and clean. These horses are going to be real spirit horses. In the sixth chapter of the book of 2 Kings, Elisha prayed that God would open his servant's eyes to see who was on his side. And God did so. And we read that there were chariots of fire and horsemen all over the mountain round about Elisha. You believe that? That's what the Bible says. In the first and sixth chapters of Zechariah, we have other horses. To make a long story short, let's just lay aside all explanation and believe it as we read it. That Christ will ride a horse, the saints of God will ride a horse, the armies of heaven, all of the armies of heaven, with the exception of the angels, will ride horses, coming in one great army to fight against the Antichrist and the kings of the earth and their army. Or, continuing this story down to verse 19 of this 19th chapter, he said, I saw the beasts and the kings of the earth and their armies gathered together against him that sat on the horse and against his army. And the beast was taken, that is the Antichrist, and with him the false prophet that wrought miracles before him. These both were cast alive into the lake of fire, burning with brimstone. Now you must remember this. The beast is symbolic of three things. The human Antichrist, an individual, a real man, who will head the eight kingdoms. So, the kingdom and the man are both involved in the one symbol of the beast. And then there's a supernatural satanic prince of Grecia, or an angelic prince, who will use the Antichrist and cause him to become successful in getting power over this eight kingdom. All three things are seen in the one symbol. A supernatural spirit out of the bottomless pit, a human Antichrist, and the eighth kingdom itself. You'll keep those three things in mind. Every statement concerning the beast will be literally clear. Here, when it says the beast was taken, that refers to the personal Antichrist. And with him, the false prophet that wrought miracles before him, these both were cast alive into the lake of fire burning with brimstone. There are 60 different statements concerning the beast in the whole of Revelation. You read some of these statements, says that the beast is a kingdom. Other statements say the beast is a man. Others say the beast is a spirit out of the bottom of the pit, or somebody out of the pit. So you must remember all three things are to be understood in the one symbol. Here the personal Antichrist, the human being we call the man of sin, the man that will dominate the eighth kingdom for the last 3.5 years. He will be taken at the battle of Armageddon, for that is what this scripture describes. He will be taken, and with him the false prophet, the kings of the earth will be taken and cast into the lake of fire. The multitude of the nations that will be under the Antichrist will be destroyed, with the exception of 1/6 part of them, as stated in Ezekiel 39, verse 2. 1/6 part God said he would leave. At that battle, blood will flow up to the horse's bridle, 160 miles long. That's pictured in the 14th chapter of Revelation, the last 5 or 6 verses, where it states that the wine or the vines, the grapes, were cast into the winepress of the wrath of God. And all the winepress came blood up to the horse's bridles, 160 miles long. Now that doesn't mean that all this river will be blood. It will be a mixture of blood and water and hail. For in the 38th chapter of Ezekiel, verses 17 to 21, God said, I will rain upon him and the many bands that are with him, overflowing rain, great hailstone, fire and brimstone. So the blood of the million slain in the battle of Armageddon, mixed with this overflowing rain and great hailstone, will make such a river. Chapter 19 of Revelation is a picture of the literal coming of Christ with the armies of heaven to fight against the Antichrist and the armies of the earth. The battle will last for one day only. According to Zechariah 14, it said to be in that day one day, not known to the Lord, neither Claire nor Doc, but at evening time there shall be light. One day Christ will get victory over all of his enemies, will seize the government of this world, and will set up a kingdom in this world forever, even forever and ever. And that will fulfill the 11th of Revelation, verse 15. It says, the kingdoms of this world are become the kingdoms of our God and of his Christ, and they shall reign forever and ever. And it will also be a fulfillment of many scores of prophecies, as we shall see as we continue. Now in chapter 19, understand it literally as a battle between the armies of heaven and the armies of the earth. And you cannot possibly misunderstand any detail of this chapter. I'm referring to chapter 19, verse 11 to 21. At that battle, going into chapter 20, we have the fact that the devil will be bound at the same time. Not only will the beast and the false prophet be taken and will be cast into the lake of fire, but we read here, I saw an angel come down from heaven having the key, the bottomless pit, and a great chain in his hand. And he laid hold on that old dragon called the devil and Satan and bound him and cast him into the bottomless pit, that he should deceive the nations no more till the 1,000 years should be finished. After that, he must be loosed a little season. Then he said, I saw thrones, and they that sat upon them, even the souls of them that were slain for the witness of Jesus, for the word of God, who had not worshipped the beast, neither his image, these lived and reigned with Christ 1,000 years. Blessed and holy is he that hath part in the first resurrection. On such the second death hath no power. Second death is the lake of fire. It has no power, but they shall be priests of God and of Christ. That is, all the resurrected saints who have part in the first resurrection, who will be resurrected before 1,000 years, they will be priests of God and of Christ, shall reign 1,000 years. But the rest of the dead, who were not blessed and holy, that is, the wicked dead, live not again till 1,000 years are finished. This is the first resurrection. Now we have not only the picture of the Battle of Armageddon in chapters 19 and 20, but we have the fact of 1,000 years' reign of Jesus Christ on the earth.